So the time has come. I can't put it off any longer. I have to pull the dash out of our 2015 Toyota RAV4. Now, if you're wondering what Toyota RAV4 I'm talking about, link's up there. It'll also explain why I'm pulling the dash out of a car that was hit in a corner. So let's get started.
So first we'll pull the headrests out. There's just a little button you press on the side. Pull them out. Makes the seats a little shorter because we're going to pull them out of there. Then we can remove the plastic caps over the bolts in the rear. Unbolt the back of the seats. Remove the caps on the front. Unbolt the fronts and tip the seats back so we can get to the wires. Unplug all of our plugs. Also, those are for airbags. And pull our seat out.
Free drugs! Eccentric tension headache.
They must have known I was going to be pulling the dash out of this and gave me a present. Thanks.
So now we're on to the other side. Now that my headache is gone, I can get back to work. Pull the little plastic caps off and unbolt the front of the seat. Tip it back. Unplug our wires. And pull the seat out. That's why we take the headrests off. Now I take out our console. I really need an extension to make this easier. I should probably go get one that's about 2 feet long. A couple bolts in the bottom, and the top lifts up. Pull the part around the emergency brake out. Just clips in. And it's also held in with coffee and pop. So we'll take the boot out that's holding lots of graham crackers and other delicious things. Throw that in the pile. There's a little coin tray up in the front. Pop that out. There's a screw underneath it. Now you can remove the shifter knob. It just spins off. Take the top of the console off. There's one plug on it. Disconnect that plug. Pull that piece of dash trim off. There's one screw underneath it. Now the whole console slides out. Lift it out of there. All these parts I'm taking off, I'm gonna go throw them in a bucket of water so that by the time I go to put them back on, I'll just dry them off and hopefully all the yummy stuff that's attached to them comes off. I'm gonna start pulling our dash apart. Pull the radio out that we just put in. Now while we're doing that, we're gonna set up the AC machine. Discharge the AC system, as we are gonna have to open it up. So, we'll set that up. And we're done. There's only supposed to be 1.24 pounds of Freon in there, I think. There was a little extra. I'd be willing to bet they added more Freon, thinking they could make it colder. And it's actually because the doors were stuck. Somebody's been here before. So now we're on to the heater hoses. Got my favorite spring clamps on there. These weren't too bad to get to, so I won't complain too much about them. Pull our heater hoses off. Now we can disconnect the AC line, jam the driver in there because I'm too lazy to go get a ratchet. Take the bolt out, slide the collar back, and pull the lines off. No, that wasn't leaking, that was actually a vacuum. The AC machine pulls it into a vacuum, so. Then I pull the sill plate up so we can get to our kick panel. It's got one little thumb screw on the back. We'll do the driver's side. It didn't have a thumb screw on the back. I'll do the A-pillar trim. Pop it out of there. Then you gotta twist the clips 90 degrees and it pops out. Putting them in is a little different. We'll do that later. So rotate the clip, pop it out. The same thing on the bottom. That's so when the airbag deploys, those trim pieces don't go flying across the car. Now you pop off the speaker grills. One bolt behind them. Same thing on the driver's side. I'm gonna pull the bezel off around the cluster. Just pops off. There's one screw on the top of the cluster on each side. Just unscrew those. Tilt the steering wheel down, give ourselves a little room. And pull the cluster out. The bottom just clips in. Once it's out, there's two plugs on the back. Now the top of the dash comes off. Got a couple airbag wires for the passenger side and a couple bolts for the airbag. Now it comes off with the top of the dash. There's those wires. And one more plug that we forgot. And the whole thing comes out of there. So if the airbag deploys, that's what you have to change. I'll pull this bezel off. It also clips on the top of the steering wheel. I just figured that out.
Yummy.
I'll pull the hush panel off underneath the driver's side dash. Got a plug in there for the tire pressure reset. Now we take the knee bolster off. There's an airbag in there. Have to unplug the airbag. Yes, I know I could use a shorter screwdriver, but again, I'm too lazy to go get more tools. Pull the carpet back a little bit so we can get to the duct that goes underneath it. Unplug the duct from the AC box. And we're gonna struggle to get it out of there because I refuse to take the carpet out. I'll learn my lesson. It's out though. So now we're gonna take out the lower piece of the dash, plastic part. Antenna wire over here. Disconnect and pull off the A-pillar. We'll pop off the top of the ductwork. Slide it out of the way. Now the defroster vents, they clip into the firewall. Unclip those, pull them out. Then we get to the bolts for the top of the dash. A couple bolts on the bottom. Got some switches over here to unplug. Pop all those out. Get the one last screw in there. And one more down in the bottom. Now our lower dash is free. Oh, one more on the top. So now we can pull that dash out. Kind of work it around the steering column. It's just plastic. Kind of bends all over the place. And every single wire seems to want to stay. So I get snagged on something. So you have to unsnag it. If you are short on patience, this would be the worst part of this job for you. I know it was testing mine. Now I'll pull the duct out of the passenger side. Except I learned my lesson. We're gonna fold the carpet back. That takes a few seconds and it's easy to get to the little clip. Pop the duct out of there and pull it out. Now we got a couple brackets in the center of the dash for the metal brace that runs across. We'll unbolt those. There's a bunch of wiring harnesses on them, so we're just going to unbolt them and set them off to the side instead of disconnecting everything. Save ourselves some time. I'm going to attempt to leave the metal part in the car, because to get that out you have to remove the steering column and everything else. So I'm going to kind of unbolt our heater box. Pull it down. See if we can wiggle it out of here. Need a little bit of room. Pull the metal brace out, slide it back. It's not going to give us much room, but hopefully it'll give us enough. Wiggle that box out. There's a lot of wiggle and pull involved in this job. So we got it. It's out of there.
So here's our old heater box, here's our new one. It takes quite a bit to move that. This one moves real easy. So instead of changing the doors in there that are messed up, I'm just gonna put this whole box in. There's all kinds of pop. Turns out I was right. You can see there's a piece of gum in there, everything's all messed up. So rather than taking it apart, cleaning it all out, replacing the doors, and taking this one apart, I'm just gonna throw this whole thing in here. This one only had 6,000 miles and it was out of a 2017. So it's 2 years newer with fewer miles. So the heater core and evaporator core should be in a little better condition as well. So it gets an upgrade and it's clean and ready to go. So we're gonna throw that in.
So now we're gonna weasel it back in there. Like a puzzle. Gotta figure out how the pieces fit. So you got the tubes for the heater hoses through there. That's the hard part. And once they get through there, it kind of slides up into place. Put the dash back up, bolt it in. I can bolt our heater box to it and to the firewall. Put our supports back in. Them to the floor and to the dash, then bolt the heater box to them. Do the same thing on the driver's side. Got a few more wires on that side. Plug in all of our heater box. What isn't run with cables? Now I put the rest of the box in. This is the part I was able to get off when the dash was still in there. It's a lot easier to put it in now. So it just clips into the other heater box and bolt it in. Add some wires that I unscrewed from the bottom. Plug those in. And put our duct back underneath. With our carpet that's folded up and makes it nice and easy to get to. Fold our carpet back down. Bye, Mr. Spotty. Ah, he climbed out. So now clip the carpet into the tabs on the side. And we'll do the driver's side vent. With this new method I invented, rolling the carpet back. put the carpet back under the dash. Side's a little harder. Got to put it underneath the pedals. Still easier than struggling with that vent though. Attach it to the clips on the side. Those clips also hold the wiring harness. The bottom opens up. You can put the carpet in there. Now you can put our lower dash piece on. Bolt it all in. Now the defroster vents. Attach it to the air box, then clip it into the firewall. We'll put the dash vent tubes in. Slide it down into the heater box and attach it. And now we can put the top of the dash on. Set it down in there. Try to keep the wiring harness from going where it's not supposed to go, because that's exactly where it wants to go. Set it into place. We'll use our belt molding installation tool, because I didn't feel like going to get the dash installation tool. Plug in our cluster. Set the bottom into place and snap it in. And screw the top in. Got a bolt that holds the dash to our airbox, so we'll put that back in. Now we'll plug in our airbag. Now we'll bolt in our airbag. Put our radio back in for the second time. Put our heater controls in. Bolt everything in. Put our clock in, dash vent. And put our cluster bezel in. We did clean off the mess that was on that boot. Snap that in there. Snap in the other dash vent. And now we can put our knee bolster airbag in. Plug it in. Set it up into place. Yes, I need a longer extension. Bolt the bottom in. And tighten up the top. We can plug in all our switches on the side and snap that trim piece in. Plug our hood latch back in. And now I put the glove box in. Bottom clips in and then it rotates up. There's a little strut that keeps it from going down too fast. Reconnect that and close it up. Put our upper dash trim on. Put our speaker grills back on. Reattach our AC lines. I decided to go get the ratchet, I guess. Slide our heater hoses on. Yay, spring clamps. Slide those back on. Now put the kick panel on the passenger side, snap it in, put our little thumb screw on there, put our sill plate in with our bumper installation tool, so I still didn't feel like getting the right tool. Put the driver's side in, and we got the hush panel on the bottom, plug it in, snap it in, and screw it in. And put the console back in. Slide it into place. Bolt the back of it in. And screw it in. Those hidden screws that are in the front. Put our little trim piece on, it covers the one. Put our coin tray in, it covers the other. Trying to put the top of the console in. I did take this all apart and clean it. The part where the shifter goes was kind of disgusting. So we'll take it out of gear just so we can get the thing lined up. Got our one plug, plug it in, and it snaps into place. Put it back in park. Put our shifter handle back on. Tighten it up. Click. I'll put the boot on for the e-brake. Nice and clean. It's only held in with clips now, not popping coffee. Slide it back into place. And our AC is done charging, 1.21 pounds. So it had about a quarter pound too much. So I got some free Freon out of the job. Disconnect it and put the caps back on. Now you put the A-pillar trim back on. Put the speaker grill on first, and A-pillar trim slides in there and snaps in. And here's how it's done. So those clips, you gotta pull them out of the A-pillar. The ones we twisted. They're just tabs you squeeze on both sides, but when the trim is in the way, they're hard to get to. So you just take the trim off, then take the clips off, then put the clips back in the trim, then put the trim back on the car. Put our gasket back up.
So our seat's kind of dirty, which is no big deal. We can clean it up, but there's a few holes in the bottom cushion here. And if there's one good thing about all the airbags in the side of the seats that destroy the seats, it's that there's a lot of these seats in the junkyard with good bottoms and good frames, bad backs and bad side airbags. So you can find cushions really cheap. So we got a good bottom cushion. It was out of a seat that had blown airbags. So I got it for nothing. So we're just gonna change this bottom seat cover. Our back is all good. We'll get rid of these holes and we don't have to clean it.
So first we'll just unstrap it. And we can unclip the front of it. The more of the seat cushion you unclip, the easier it gets. First clips are the hardest, so do the easiest to get to. Now we'll disconnect that side piece. Pull the side trim back so we get to the clips for the cushion. There's a cover in the back. That one strap that goes back there. And we pull our cushion out.
In the pile.
Yeah, that's right. I missed. That's why I fix cars and not play basketball. So we'll put our new cushion in there. Put the strap back up there. Start clipping in the clips on the bottom of the seat. Do the hard to get to ones first. They do get harder to attach as you go along. So put our cover back on the side, line it up and clip it in. Reattach the back of the cushion, and we'll reattach the side. Put our trim back up, put our elastic back in. Test it, make sure it's stretchy. And we can clip the front end.
So our new cushion is installed. Still a little dirty, but detail will get that. Throw it back in. So I know what you're thinking. Is he really gonna put that seat in without vacuuming the carpet underneath? And the answer is, absolutely. And the reason is, I already cleaned the console, and I don't want the clean freaks to think that I actually listened to them in the comments. So I'm gonna throw it in and leave the carpet dirty. How do you like that?
So we'll set the seat in, tip it back so we get to all of our plugs. And then we'll bolt it in. Little plastic caps to snap in there. Slide the seat forward so we can get to the back bolts. Tighten them down and put our caps in. Slide our headrest back in. Make sure they're fully engaged. And we'll give in to the clean freaks. Vacuum the carpet up a little bit. I'm not cleaning it, I'm just vacuuming it.
So after you've done one, they get much easier. This side, we're also gonna put this outer piece on because our other one is broke. So, do this the fast way. Now our new trim and seat bottom is installed. Ready to put it back in the car.
So we'll set the seat in. Tip it back. And plug it in. Bolt in the front. Plastic caps. Bolt in the rear. Some more plastic caps. Slide the headrest down. And move Mr. Spotty. So now we can pull our heater box apart. See what it looks like inside. That was all you had to do to take the heater core out. One bolt, it slides out. Pull the bottom cover off. Now we gotta pull the expansion valve out. Pull the evaporator core out. And here's our bad doors. That little opening isn't supposed to be covered up. A little plastic piece is folded under. Top piece off and a little gear. Now we can get to it. So that little folded over part kept folding under and covering up the door, which was probably making it a little warm in there. So the pop must have stuck it together, and then when they opened it up, it folded over, and once that plastic folded, it never unfolded. There's no way to straighten it out, but I had to replace it. Everything we did, plus what I just did here, is what we had to do to fix it. And then we would have to clean out the whole heater box. In the pile.
So that's about as far as I want to go today. It wasn't the worst dash I've ever done, but it also wasn't the easiest. And since I did the work of two people with all that cleaning, I'm exhausted. It's time to pack it up and call it a day. So next time we come back, we'll throw it all together, we'll make it better than before the accident, and get this thing back on the road. So like this video if you found it interesting, share it if you think somebody else might. Subscribe to see what our RAV4 console holds for us next time. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.